next class, we are having the two types of variables. One is instance variable and one is class variable. Instance variable or a class variable. What exactly is that? I'm going to give you the demonstration. I'm going to create a Python file. Suppose my file name is a.py. What I am saying, types of variable in a class. We are having the two types of variable in a class. One is instance variable. And the second one is the class variable. We are having the concept of instance variable and we are having the concept of class variable. Instance variable means what? Belongs to instance. And class variable means what? Belongs to class. So what exactly is that? Okay, suppose I'm going to define a class and I'm going to create a class called A. A is the name of my class. In this A class, what I'm going to define, I'm just going to start with the constructor. So I'm just going to write def __ init. And I'm just going to put some variables nothing wrong with this. And I'm just going to define the instance variable over there, self dot. Nm is equal to, and suppose I'm going to write like the name is Santosh, and again I'm going to define like self dot number is equal to, and suppose this is the mobile number we are having. Yeah, remember, if I'm going to create a variable within the init method, this is basically, it's an instance variable. Why it's an instance variable? Okay, I'm going to give you the example. Like, I'm going to create the object of class A. Suppose I'm writing z is equal to A. So z is what? It's an object of class A. Now what we can do, again I'm going to create the another class. Suppose I'm going to create k is equal to A. So we are having the two different instance. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to display like print, and I'm going to display z.nm, comma, I'm going to put some spaces over there, comma, z.no. Nothing wrong with that. And again, I'm going to use the same thing over here, like I'm going to write print, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use k.nm, and again, I'm going to give the k.number. Nothing wrong with that. These are the object of the class, and by the use of these object we are calling this instance variable. Nothing is the problem, and if I'm going to run this, it will work for me. Yeah, we are getting the output like Santosh and this one. It's fine. My statement was the instance variable belongs to instance. What does it mean? Okay, right now this is the value you are going to assign within the init method. That's why this value is get assigned to z also, and this value get assigned to k also. What I can do, I can make the changes also. Like, I'm just going to give like z.nm is equal to, suppose I'm going to give like ln, okay, and I'm just going to give k.nm is equal to, and suppose I'm just going to give like Robert. See, both the instance, both the object having the name attribute is there. In this particular name, I am going to define the Ellen. In this particular name, I am going to define the Robert. And if not, again, I am going to make the changes with the number also, like mobile number. So I'm just going to make the changes like this. This is the mobile number for Ellen. And I'm just going to make the changes like this. K dot NO is equal to. And I'm going to make the changes for this. Now, if I'm going to display this. Now, this Z dot NM and this Z dot NO has nothing to do with this K dot NM and K dot NO. So this particular instance variable is belongs to instance. It belongs to the object. Like if I'm going to run this, see, we are going to get the output. Run this. Yeah, we are going to get the output. Like we are getting Ellen and we are getting the Robert. So for the Robert and mobile number, for the K we are having the different values for the NM and NO. For the Z we are having the different value for the NM and NO. Like this is what, this is the example of instance variable. Instance variable means what? That belongs to the instance, number one. Number two, the instance variable we need to define within the init method in Python. So this is the init method, and I'm going to call this like self.nm, self.no, and we are getting this value over there. Now, the second thing is we are having the class variable, and what my statement is, class variable belongs to a class, that's good. So how we can define the class variable? If I need to define the class variable, what we need to use, we just need to declare the variable outside the init method. So this is what, this is my, these are the instance attribute, these are the instance variable, and I'm going to define the class variable. How we can define the class variable? I'm just going to make it like suppose I'm just going to give like name is there, number is there. Suppose I'm going to give like qualification, or I'm just going to give like address. And suppose address I'm going to assign address is equal to, and I'm just going to give like address is equal to like USA. Yeah, this is the class variable. The first thing we need to understand, like class variable belongs to a class. Belongs to a class means what? Now the second thing, this is the common property, that this is basically the common values that going to assign for the K also and for the Z also. How we can call this class variable over here? I'm just going to write print, what is the name of the class? A dot, and my class variable is address. So I'm just going to call the A dot address. Run this. If I'm going to run, execute this, we're getting the output like, okay, it's a USA. So the first thing, we can call the class variable directly by the name of class because it belongs to class. And we can also access using this also, like here I'm going to give the access of the class variable. So by the use of object even you can call this. I'm just going to write z dot address. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. Again, I'm going to call like this, like I'm going to do z dot address. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. But the thing is that it's not going to change for any variables. Like it's not going to change for the Z or K. It's a common values that going to access by both the object. So that's basically the class variable. If I'm going to run this, see, we are getting Santosh and all. This is the result of this. And finally, we are getting like Ellen. This is the mobile number and this is the address we are getting over here. So what we can say, like we can access the class variable using the class name, as well as we can also access using the object name. And suppose if I want to make some changes over there, how we can do that? Yeah, we can make the changes, that's not a problem, but that changes has to reflect on both every objects. Like if I'm going to call using Z or if I'm going to call using K, that will get reflected over here. Suppose I'm going to make the changes, I'm just going to write a dot address is equal to, I'm just going to give like India. Now, if I'm going to run this, if I'm going to execute this, here we are getting the India, India, India. Remember, the changes is not going to apply for the individual object. Can we make the changes like z.address is equal to India? Try to run this. Yeah. z.address get changed for the India. Like, but this is not the way to use the class variable. Here we make the changes, it's perfectly fine. But this is not the genuine way to use the class variable like this. So ideally we should use the class variable over here. Ideally we should use the class variable over here, and that will be common for all. So this is what, this is the class variable we are having, and this is what, this is the instance variable we are having. So we are having the two types of variable over there. One is the instance variable, belongs to instance. If I am going to define any variable by the use of like self, like this, within the init, it's an instance variable. If I am going to declare a variable outside of the init method, like this, it's a class variable. Class variable is also known as static variable. Remember, class variable is also known as static variable. Class variable is also known as static variable. Both are the same thing. Either we can say it's a class variable or it's a static variable, is the same thing. So this is the example of class variable as well as the instance variable, and this is how we can call it. So this is what exactly the types of variable we are having. Got it? Yeah. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to make the copy of this. I'm going to copy this in the notepad, that will be better. So we are having the two types of variable is there. One is the instance variable, or the, and the second one is we are having the class variable. Class variable or static variable belongs to class. Instance variable, it belongs to instance. And this is how we can access this. That's really not good for the Python. It's always create like regarding the class and object, like a lot of confusions are there. Like this is the common concept. This concept is applicable in Java. This concept is applicable in .NET. In every particular programming language, this concept is there. But in Python, it's an unexpected kind of thing. See, if I'm going to make z.address, even by the use of object, you can make the changes with the class variable. That's really, it should not be like. See, if I'm going to make the changes like this, yeah, it's get changed. This is not the good way, like this is not the real way to use the class variable. So ideally we should not do this. So this is exactly the class variable and instance variable. Yeah. Okay, so this was the concept of the class variable and instance variable. Now what I'm going to define, like we are going to talk about types of methods. Types of method. So we are having the two types of, like we are having the two types of variables. So of course we are having the two types of method, but it's not exactly like that. We are having the three types of method. One is the instance method. One is the instance method. One is the class method. And one is the static method. Oh. Now the static method is different from the class method. That's good. So we are having the three types of method is there in Python. One is instance method, one is class method, and one we are having the static method. So what exactly the instance method is? I'm going to define a class. I'm going to define a class. Remember, ideally the instance method work on instance variable. Ideally the class method work on the class variable. If we need to handle the instance variable, I will go for the instance method. If I need to handle the class variable, I will go for the class method. So how we can do that? I am just going to define, okay, initially I am just going to start with the instance method. How we can create that? Suppose I am going to define a class, and suppose my class is A. This is the name of the class. What I am going to do, we need to create the instance method. So naturally we need to define some instance variable. on that we will work on. So I'm going to define like def underscore init, and I'm just going to put like some variables over there. Okay, I'm just going to give some variable like m1 comma m2 I'm going to define. Okay, now I'm writing self dot m1 is equal to m1. Again I'm writing self dot m2 is equal to m2. So this m1 and m2 is what? This m1 and m2 that we are talking about, this is what? This is basically, it's a instance variables we are having. Instance variable means what? It belongs to the instance. Now what I'm going to do, suppose we need to manage these variables over there. Suppose what? Okay, this is how we can create the object of the class. I'm going to create the object like z is equal to a, and I'm going to pass the values like 22 and 33. That's good. Now what I need to do, I need to display the sum of these numbers. And suppose I'm going to use def underscore def. I'm just going to create a method over there, and suppose my method is like sum. So I'm going to create a sum method, and I'm going to use the keyword self over there, because we need to work on these number like m1 and m2. So I'm just going to write like print, I'm just writing self dot m1 plus self dot m2. It's perfectly fine. So these are the instance variable and these are the instance method. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to call this method. I'm just calling like z dot sum. Perfectly fine. It's going to display me the values like this. If I'm going to run this, yeah, we are getting 55. Nothing wrong with that. So this is the instance variable, and to handle the instance variable, we require the instance method. So I'm just going to apply like this. Def sum is of self and all, and we are defining this method. That's good. So this is what? This is the example of instance method. Instance method is going to work on the instance. It's going to work with the instance. Suppose I'm going to, what does it mean? It works on the instance. Suppose I'm going to create the another instance, like p is equal to a, and I'm going to pass this value over there. Now, if I'm going to call p.sum, see, initially we are going to get the output like, initially we are getting 55. So this sum method is going to work on these z attributes, these z variables, and this p.sum is going to return me like this. So this is the example of the instance method. Now, so this is the example of the instance method. I'm just going to make it copy. Like the instance method is going to work with the instance variable. I'm just going to make it copy over here. Okay. Now, what I need to discuss with, it's a class method. So if I want to define a class method, so for that we need to declare some variables over there. So I'm just going to define a variables over there, like country is equal to, suppose I'm going to give the country is equal to USA. This is what? This is the class variable we are having. It's a class variable. And to work on the class variable, what we have to use? We have to use the class method. So how we can create the class method over there? So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create a class method. I'm just going to create a class method. Remember, I'm just going to use the class method over there. So I'm just going to pass like, suppose my method is def cinfo, country info I'm going to call. And remember, in the instance method, normally we need to pass the self. Self is what? It's a reference of the same class. But in this method, like it's a cinfo, I'm going to create the class method. In this, normally we use the keyword CLS over there. In the place of self, we should use the CLS. CLS represents, it's a class method. It's not necessary to use the CLS. It can be any keyword, but it is just like self. It's not necessary to use the self only. You can use the A, B, C, X, Y, Z, but the standard is self. The same thing, we can also use the self over there. That's not a problem. But the important thing is, like, because we are going to define a class method, so normal standard is we should use the CLS over there. So I'm just going to write CLS. Now what I need to do, I just need to display the country. So I'm just going to write print like CLS dot, what we need to display, I need to display the country. So I'm just going to call the country. Now what I need to do, I just need to call this method. So how I'm going to call this method? We can simply call this method using the class name, or even by the use of object name we can call this method, z.cinfo. Again, we can also call like p.cinfo. It will be common for all. Now if I'm going to run this, this is how we can call the class method. Now the problem is, like, if I'm going to run this, I'm going to get the error, like, and the error is okay, it's perfectly fine. Basically the thing is that right now in this, basically we are using the PyCharm environment, it's perfectly fine, but might be you will get some problem over there. It will ask you to pass the reference of the CLS, it's a this variable. So the ideal option will be, if you are going to create a class method over there, the better option will be like always pass decorator over there, and I am just going to write decorator over there, like @class method. So this is basically the decorator. This is the decorator which we need to use. So I'm just going to use the decorator over there, @class method, and if I'm going to run this, it's perfectly fine. It's going to work for me. Yeah, we are getting the US over there, the country information. So this is what exactly the class method is. Remember, the class method is going to work with the class variable, number one. In the class method, we need to use the decorator @class method, number two. Number three, in the class method, we don't need to use the self. Self is basically for the instance method. If I need to use the class method, we should apply the CLS. And this is how we can call the class method, that this is what exactly the class method is. So this is the example of class method. It's a class method as well as instance method. There, this is the instance method. And this is basically we are having the class method. Now one important thing is there, then what is the static method? Like the types of variable, there was the two types of variable. One was the class variable and one was the instance variable, and one was the class variable. Class variable is also known as a static variable. Now we are calling the method like a static method. So what exactly the static method is? Remember, a static method, we cannot say the class method as a static method. A static method is different from the class method and instance method. And why we use this? Like, remember, in the instance method you need to pass the attribute, like you are passing self. In the class method you are passing the CLS. But what I want to do, I want to do something extra. Remember, instance method is going to work with the instance variable. Class method is going to work with the class variable. Now, what I want to do, I want to do something extra. And that extra has nothing to do with the class variable as well as the instance variable. Then how we can do that? What I want to do, see, try to understand. Instance method is for the instance variable. Class method is for the class variable. But now what I want to do, I want to define a method that will be that particular method has nothing to do with the instance variable or the class variable. Then what we should do for that particular scenario, what we can do, we can create the static method. What we can do, we can just create the static method. So how we can do that? I'm just going to write like def display, and I'm not going to put anything over here. This is the example of a static method. It's a blank. I'm not going to put anything over there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to display like print a static method. Now something is wrong, some error message is there. If I'm going to put the cursor, method must have first parameter usually called self, like this is the thing. So basically we want to define the static method. A static method has nothing to do with the class, nothing to do with the object. So that's why we don't need to give any parameters over there, but still I'm getting the error. So how we can solve this? Like for the class method, we can use the decorator class method. For the static method, we can use the decorator called static method. Now it's perfectly fine. See, nothing is wrong with over there. Now I'm going to call this static method over there. I'm just going to write a dot display. Yeah, perfectly fine. Even we can call using the object p dot display. Nothing wrong with that. I'm going to run this. Yeah, we are getting the static method like this. So this is a static method. To define the static method, we need to use the decorator @static method. Remember, someone can ask you the question, what is the difference between class method and the static method? Remember, in the class method you need to pass the reference of the class, but in the static method we don't need to pass any parameters. In the class method we need to use the decorator @class method, but in the static method we need to use the decorator @static method. So this is what exactly the static method, this is the class method. Remember, class method is going to work on the class variable, instance method is going to work on the instance variable. A static method has nothing to do with the class variable or the instance variable. This is what exactly the static method is. Got this? This is really the good conceptual concept we need to remember. So I'm just, yeah, please. Okay, so yeah, you want to call this variable. See, here I'm not going to pass the CLS, here I'm not going to pass the like self. Now what we can do, we can create the object of the class. Suppose I'm going to write p is equal to a. Yeah, now I'm going to call p dot, what method I'm going to call, like sum. Yeah, this is how we can do this. Yeah, so this is how we can do this. Because see, we don't have the self, so it's not possible to me for like, if I'm going to display like print m1, how we can do that? Because it's not going to recognize the m1. Even we are going to use self.m1, still we are getting the error. It's not going to recognize the self. That's why, that's only the thing that we can apply. So this is the concept of a static method, instance method and class method. Got it? Okay, that's good. It's already copy over there. Now the next important thing is there in the Python, like see, right now we are just familiar with the types of variables, we are familiar with the types of methods over there. Now one important thing we are having the concept of properties. What exactly the properties? We are having the concept of property. What exactly the properties? Remember, in Python as such we don't have the direct like what we can do, we can create the getter and setter over there and then we can apply the properties concepts over there. I'm just going to show you how we can do this. Suppose before explaining the property, I'm going to do some practical stuff with you, like okay, remove this. So this is my class. What I'm going to do, I need to define some private variables over there. So I'm just going to write def def underscore underscore init, and suppose I'm going to define a private variable like I'm just going to write like name is equal to, this is the default value I'm going to give, like name is equal to Santosh. Yeah, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write self dot underscore underscore name underscore name is equal to, if I'm going to put the double underscore, it's a private variable, so I'm just going to write self dot underscore underscore name is equal to, and I'm just going to give like name. Yeah, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with this. So this is the instance variable we are having. Now what I'm going to do, I want to set the values for the name, I want to set the value. So what I'm going to use, I'm just going to use def, and I'm going to give the name of the method like set name. I'm just going to write like def set name, and yeah, I'm just going to pass this one, and here I'm just writing self dot name is equal to like whatever the value I'm going to give here, it's name. Yeah, perfectly fine, and better I'm going to put the values keyword over there. Yeah, so name is equal to what, it's a value. So we are having the set method. In the set method, I'm just going to define the values, and again I'm going to write the def get name. I'm just going to write like get name, and here again I'm going to pass like self, and again I'm going to return what we need to return, like self dot underscore underscore name. So we are having the setter, we are having the getter. See, explicitly we are defining the method over there, it's a setter and getter. Like in other programming language, we are having the some different syntax is there, but it's not in the case of Python. It's a simple, you need to create a method, it can be anything, like it can be A and B and C, but it's a standard. If you want to set the values, use the set name. If you want to get the values, use the get name. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create the object of this. So I'm just going to write z is equal to a. Yeah, it's an object, and I'm going to keep the values for, like, suppose I'm going to give Rajesh. Now nothing wrong with this, I'm just going to use like print z dot get name. If I'm going to run this, get name is the method and it's going to return the name, so we are getting Rajesh, nothing wrong with this. Okay, what I'm going to do, I want to put some values for the underscore underscore name. So what we can do, we can use z dot set name, and in the set name I'm going to give the value, like suppose I'm going to give the value like Anil, and again I'm going to call z dot get name. So this will call the set method, you are calling the set method, you are calling the get method. So this is how we can do this. If I'm going to run this, yeah, we are getting the Rajesh. First time we are getting the Rajesh, and the second time we are getting the Anil after calling the set. So this is what exactly the set and get. But this set and get method